from the paper-wrapped disposable bamboo sets at Chinese takeouts to Japanese sushi counters, chopsticks have come a long way, boasting a history of around 3,500 years, dating back at least to the Shang Dynasty. The modesty of this unique utensil was a key piece of ancient Chinese civilization. The Chinese word for chopstick is kuaizi, which literally translates to quick bamboo and has the same meaning as the English common sayings of chop chop or quickly. Welcome to Tea with Erping. Last week over lunch at a Chinatown restaurant, my American friend told me that he has been eating with chopsticks ever since he saw a classical Chinese dance called Chopstick Zest, performed by the Shenyun Performing Arts. He later looked up chopsticks on the internet and was amazed by these ancient dining utensils, and urged me to do a video on chopsticks. I found it to be a terrific idea, hence this production. The man responsible for making this unique utensil a household choice was none but Confucius himself, a vegetarian who believed and practiced in living a benevolent and gentle life. His wisdom cast a widespread influence on the dining etiquette of ancient China. He said, "The honorable and upright man keeps well away from both the slaughterhouse and the kitchen. He allowed no knives on his table, as a knife would remind him of a weapon instead of an instrument for eating. He also thought that knife's sharp points evoked violence and warfare, in contrast to being in a happy, contented mood as one should be during meals." The reflection of gentleness is profound in Chinese food. For example, food should be in bite-sized pieces so that diners can pick it up delicately with a pair of chopsticks. Such a refined dining manner promotes a noble quality. Chopsticks are an auspicious gift representing happiness, often given to newlyweds or for well wishes. This humble utensil comes in many varieties, from bamboo to gold, jade, and even ivory. Some are also embellished with carvings of beautiful scenery or meaningful calligraphies. In the Tang Dynasty, when the emperor gave a pair of chopsticks to an official, it was to compliment his righteous character. Yet, these ancient chopsticks almost got banned in the 1980s. Hu Yaobang, the General Secretary of the Communist Party of China then, suggests that the people of China start switching from chopsticks to knives and forks. He was known for being overly eager to apply Western styles of doing things to erase traditional Chinese customs. He said on a trip to Inner Mongolia in 1984, "We should prepare more knives and forks, buy more plates, and sit around the table to eat Chinese food in the Western style, that is, each from his own plate." 2 years later, he lost his job for being a big mouth and pushing too hard to westernize China. Yet he was widely considered a reformer within the communist system. Scholars have even divided the world into three parts. First, finger feeders, or those who eat with hands. Second, fork feeders, or those who eat with forks and knives. And third, chopstick feeders, or those who eat with chopsticks. Interesting, isn't it? Nowadays, chopsticks are widely used in Japan, Korea, Hong Kong, Taiwan, and many Southeast Asian countries. But if you take a closer look, there's a distinctive difference between the shape of chopsticks in China, Japan, and Korea. In China, a pair of chopsticks made from an equal length stick around 10.6 inches. This standard length in Chinese is 七寸六分长, 7 Chinese inches and 6 minutes. Legend has it that it represents 7 sentiments and 6 desires in Buddhist theology, reminding us to control ourselves while eating. Commonly made of bamboo or wood, the tapered and round end depicts heaven, and the square top represents the earth. The fingers that hold the chopsticks stand for humanity, which is nourished by heaven and earth. In Japan, chopsticks are shorter and sharper than Chinese ones, with heavy tails and pointy heads measuring around 6 to 9 inches. These days, chopsticks in Korea are often made of steel, slim and flat in size, but heavy in weight and 9 inches in length. Does it make you wonder why the difference when they are all categorized as chopsticks? I'll share with you the fascinating secret behind their shape. It lies within the practice of eating in the respective regions. Chinese people have the tradition of eating together, the more the greater joy, usually sitting at one big round table. Food is to be shared and placed in the middle of the table. It's also a common courtesy to pick up food and give it to another person at the table. Hence, the long chopsticks are ideal as you will be maneuvering around the whole table. Chopsticks are also a common cooking utensil. Its long shape is ideal for stirring, mixing food in the frying pan. Eating together with family and friends increases social connections and feelings of well-being. It's part of the community culture in China. In Japan, contrary to the Chinese form of hospitality, it's uncommon to pick and pass food to others. It's considered impolite and a form of contamination. Food comes in individual portions, hence shorter lengths is sufficient to eat from one's bowl. The sharp point of Japanese chopsticks makes it easier to pick up the flesh of fish and debone them, which is convenient as the Japanese consume plenty of fish dishes. They are also abiding by the rites of Zhou, a Chinese classic, where one eats individual unshared dishes. This is known as yanxi, meaning to dine separately, and one's chopsticks are only allowed to move in front of oneself. This way of dining, where one sits and eats solemnly, stemmed from early ancient Chinese aristocratic dining etiquette. As William Horman said, "Manners makes the man." The Japanese surely are well known worldwide to be one of the most polite ethnicity. Lastly, the heavyweight champion of chopsticks. Korean delicacies involve plenty of grilled meat. I'm sure we are all quite familiar with Korean barbecue. It sure is one of my favorite dishes. Apart from that, in comparison to the light Japanese taste of food, Korean food involves plenty of acidic sauce, spice, and not to forget, kimchi. Wooden chopsticks are easily contaminated and burned. Wood is also not as durable as metal when dealing with acids. Wood supplies are also an issue as Korea does not have as many trees. Going back to history, in the Baekje period, the royal family used silver chopsticks to detect poison in their food. Silver changes color when it comes in contact with certain poisonous chemicals, and the common people also started using metal for their chopsticks. Due to the smooth surface of stainless steel, the flat and slim shape is only appropriate to enable one to pick up food easily. Now, let's learn a little about the etiquette of using chopsticks. It's poor etiquette to tap your chopsticks on your bowl or plates, as it's a sign that beggars use to attract attention. It's acceptable to shovel your rice from your bowl to your mouth using your chopsticks to eat it. One should never place the chopsticks vertically in the bowl, as it symbolizes feeding the dead in Chinese rituals. When seated for a meal, it's only polite to let the elders begin to take up their chopsticks before the younger ones follow. Chopsticks should not be placed in your mouth for too long, let alone licked. As it's a sign of poor manners, yes, leave the sauce to befriend the rice. They'll make the perfect pair. The passing of food should not be done from one chopstick to another. One should always place given food into the recipient's plate or bowl. Nowadays, serving chopsticks or community-used chopsticks are used to transfer food from dish plate to your plate. If none is available, it's only polite to use the other end of your chopsticks to transfer the food. When not in use, chopsticks must be placed side by side neatly on the table. One should place the front end on the rest beside your bowl. Do consider your chopsticks as an extension of your fingers. It's rude to point your chopsticks outward to people during a meal when talking to them. One should never use chopsticks to dig or find food in a bowl or plate, as is widely known in Chinese culture as digging one's grave, and it's an extreme sign of poor manners. Placing your chopsticks on top of your bowl means that I'm done, while placing it on the side or on the rest means that you are still working on your meal. There's a philosophy that guides the right way to use the chopsticks. How should one use chopsticks in the right manner? When holding chopsticks, the fingers naturally assume three positions, with the thumb and index fingers on top, and the ring and the little fingers below, while the middle finger is situated between the two sticks. First, hold the upper part of the chopsticks, keep it aligned, and do not cross it. Then hold it with your thumb, index, middle, and third fingers. One of the sticks should lean against your third finger, while the other one leans on your middle finger. Lastly, when picking on your dishes, use the index and middle finger to control the sticks. The ring and little finger supporting each other below the lowest chopstick represent the Dao, or the people living on Earth. The index finger and thumb on top that moves the chopstick represent flexibility and stability, or the heavenly laws. The middle finger between the two sticks symbolize the difficult but honorable position of the monarchy, who must simultaneously address the needs of people while abiding by virtue and law. The pair of sticks that make up a chopstick represents the balance of yin and yang. Putting in too little force, you cannot pick up any food, while with too much force, you cannot even move to open the chopsticks. Just like humans have to coordinate well in the family and community to achieve great cooperation and unity. There's so much wisdom to learn from a pair of chopsticks. Chopsticks must be straight or they won't work. That's how a person should be. Upright, honest, and fair. The length of two chopsticks must be the same, or else you will have problem using them. Unity generates power. As we say in Chinese, you can break one chopstick easily, but you cannot break a pair as easily. A pair of chopsticks must be in sync with the coordination and control. The same applies to our daily life. We must be righteous and live in the spirit of cooperation and harmony. Studies have proven that the regular use of chopsticks helps improve memories and raises one's intelligence. It's also a good way of practicing your hands if you wish to learn calligraphy or write in Chinese. Oscar Wilde once lamented, "The world was my oyster, but I used the wrong fork." Indeed, he should have thought of using chopsticks. All that food talk is making me a bit hungry. My chopsticks and a bowl of dumplings, alongside a cup of green tea, are actually waiting for me in the kitchen. Until next time, peace and tea be with you.